Everybody, this is Matt from remove-malware.com. I'm taking off for the next few days here, do some partying, and I thought I'd go ahead and get some reviews out of the way. So I'm going to do Super Anti-Spyware, and that would be the free version of Super Anti-Spyware. That's just an on-demand scanner. They haven't sent me the paid version. I requested it, but, you know, I'm still waiting. I'm also going to be reviewing Sunbelt's Viper. A representative from Sunbelt contacted me today and gave me a copy to eval to review. So they were very nice. So I'm going to go ahead and review Viper as well. I'm excited about that one. A lot of people come to my website looking for a Viper review, and I don't have one yet, so I'm going to go ahead and make one. Anyway, this review is about Super Anti-Spyware. I use Super Anti-Spyware, I'd say, just about every day because I'll load an antivirus and then I'll load malware bytes and Super Anti-Spyware. And that's kind of where I leave my clients. So they have a real-time antivirus scanner and then two other, you know, a second and third opinion, basically. So the PC is a little bit different today. It's been on for 24 hours, and it's got a lot of new stuff. I woke up this morning to see basically this. Looks like some kind of rogue antivirus page. I think it's XP, Win Antivirus 2008. Just a lot of new junk on here now. I'm hoping I can actually do the review. Look at all this crap. So anyway, I have a Super Anti-Spyware on here getting ready to install it. A few more rogue applications installed overnight. I've got Drive Cleaner and Micro Antivirus. I had to deal with that earlier this week. No biggie. Also have something called Registry Defender Platinum. And the PC is rebooting randomly. I did install Firefox. Everyone wanted to see Firefox. Let's just go ahead and get on with this review. This is going to be a short one because I know Super Anti-Spyware is so easy to install. There is one complaint I have with it. It doesn't install in safe mode, and they use a Microsoft Windows installer, which is a real bummer. You know, it's just horrible that you can't install in safe mode. You need to be able to do that. Sometimes you can only get into safe mode. So I hope they change their installer someday. Anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and install a default copy of it. Like I said, I use it every day. It's got a really great detection rate. And usually does a full cleanup upon reboot, meaning it'll mark things for deletion, whatever, when I reboot. So I'm going to go ahead and download the latest Super Anti-Spyware definitions. This is a small program. You know, you can carry it on basically a really tiny USB drive. It's really tiny, really quick to install. Really fast scanner, downloads updates really fast, works on a bootable CD. I mean, it's just a little workhorse. I love it. It does miss some things. I mean, I know that because I use it every day. But like I said, it's just the second and third opinion. They ask for an email notification. I'm not going to do that right now. Automatically check for program updates and definition updates. Definitely want that. Send a diagnostic report. Sure, they should see this machine. You don't have to do that, and I never do it when I'm at a client because it could take, I don't know, a couple minutes just to send a report sometimes. So it's preparing my report. And Super Anti-Spyware, I'm pretty sure it won the vote on my site. By the way, I hope everyone likes the new site. It's a new theme I put together. But yeah, it's got like 40 something votes, and the other ones are in the teens, I think. So I'm just going to go ahead and review this now. Anyway, this is a pretty neat thing. When you guys get browser hijackers, a lot of times they'll hijack your homepage and change it. Super anti-spyware can prevent that, and it does a hell of a job at it, too. I'm just going to go ahead and put it in google.com and say protect that homepage. And I can go ahead and block changes. So you can see automatically right there it was trying to change what I told Super anti-spyware to protect. So anyway, I'm going to go into preferences. There's just a few preferences I set in here. I terminate memory threats before quarantining, if it can, actually. Sometimes it can't. Real-time protection, I am not paying for it. Like I said, if a super anti-spyware representative sees this review and wants to send me a copy, I'll go ahead and review it again. And don't send me any cracked copies. I have too many companies following me now. I have to stay legit. Okay. I can also automatically check for program and definition updates every 8 hours. Go ahead and do that. Oh, that's right. They want me to upgrade for that. I guess I won't right now. So the big one that I had to set was really this terminate memory threats before quarantining. I don't think there's anything else that I usually mess with. I guess I'll go ahead and close browsers before scanning. That's another one that I sometimes do, but not often. And I'll go ahead and hit close right there. I'm going to scan my computer. And we're going to do a complete scan. And it's just going to find a ton of stuff, I guarantee it. Super anti-spyware has a massive detection rate. It detects a lot of stuff. Not everything, but a ton of stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and disconnect my network card because I'm done updating. I don't need to be sending out any port scans across the network. And when we come back, I'll go ahead and show you the results and talk a little more about this review. So I'll be right back.